Welcome back to Public Forum. In this segment of Public Forum, we are going to talk about whether who's really responsible for the sorry state of the culture, whether it's the media, the market forces, and who else. So from solutions to make more and more money, expand your businesses, and from yantra, mantra, vidya, all is being sold on television, sometimes by glamorous people, mostly by monstrous looking people. But let us hear it from you, Ms. Vasanthi. How would you like to look at this face of the media? Everything is saleable on television.
Shalini, popular media from the ages have always framed the citizen in that fight. The consumer wins and the citizen loses. Unfortunately, as Vijayalakshmi was talking earlier, one of the multiple factors that has affected in us going through this deterioration is also that in a democracy, the role of a citizen is very key. But the systematic deterioration of the role of citizen is being dominated by this consumeristic values. So the institutions that we have to strengthen the democracy are falling apart purely because nobody is proactive. As she said, we sit in our houses and say, "Wo kyun nahi karte? Government kyun nahi karte?" We like to sit back and couch potatoes and comment on everything. Yeah, but ourselves, we never take action. We don't like something on TV, nobody complains. If we don't want something that is bothering us, we don't go and we've given up on the state. We've given up on ourselves for that matter. And that bothers me. And this slow...
Be stronger. Why can't environmentalists have a take on the issues of the crackers? Why are they silent on the market?
Unfortunately, the state is also taken over by the market forces.
Yeah, that's
as
true.
You can say, argue on that
definitely,
also.
Definitely. So I think what we need to see is the nexus here. The nexus between the state, the market, and the other forces that are around us. And also, for that matter, where is the other voices? Who are the voices who are going to resist it? Most of them are marginalized. The people who would like to resist it, whether it is a group of environmentalists, or it's the tribals whose voices we can't hear, or it's the Dalits who are suffering, or it's the children who are making those crackers in particular factories and are getting killed because of that, we are never going to know, because those are the silent stories. So that's the appalling state of affairs. But having said that, I think the media has played majorly proactive roles in certain other areas, raising these issues, especially about environmental pollution or about corruption. So I think there is hope there. And I think we need to push the activists working on women's issues, that it is the media whom you can go to.
True.
Actually, there is no other space for us. So the media here sometimes becomes the devil's advocate, but sometimes it seems to be our only hope. So I see...
I want to add here, because Vijayalakshmi put a very big important point, that the media, it does bring up issues whenever it does. However, they get lost because
that's
of
right.
the credibility of the whole medium. It is, after all, a market force,
that's
and
right.
absolutely no accountability. Our MPs, for example, are accountable to the people who vote for them. Who is the media accountable to for today? So if a media house I know is owned by an industrialist is giving a story and tomorrow it talks about Shivkasi,
isn't it wrong on the part of a broadcaster to allow such a thing to happen?
Absolutely.
And also forget its own responsibility. You might be causing a damage to your society, to yourself, to your culture. I mean, even if we are not sensitive to our culture, at least that is happening. At least, if not media, we can blame both these forces, market forces.
Soma Jyotir Gamaya. Okay, now that simply translated means from darkness to light. Now, the idea of lighting a lamp on Diwali night is actually connected to the idea of illuminating the self, which is from inside. Which is when you close your eyes, and all the holy books of the world say that everything that exists within you. Whatever corrections have to happen within you. So the idea of lighting a lamp was essentially the lamp of gyan, the lamp of detachment. It was not about buying lamps for 5,000 rupees and telling your fellow servant at home to go, put all the lights up and at
a
particular point. There was no question of an exhibitionism. And talking about the time when Sri Ram came back home, historically speaking, At that time, the lamps which were lit in his, out of love, were visit each other on Diwali night. Diwali night was supposed to be a little pious. Mm. It was supposed to be at home. Whereas now, I mean, all of us are living in Delhi, and I'm connected to Punjab. I know for a fact that in Punjab and in Delhi, the entire middle class is indulging in gambling the whole night through. Mm. It is absolutely shameful for us to be talking about gambling on Diwali night. But I'm glad that at least one TV channel is, wanting to do it.
Hmm.
Because everybody is busy on that night, not doing what the guru has told them to do, but doing quite the opposite. Hmm. Now, we all remember what happened to the Pandavas thanks to gambling. How is gambling going to help anybody? I mean, it is one of those things which is going to destroy feelings, destroy families, destroy relationships.
And it's responsibility, but I would actively blame the civil society also.
Yes, civil society.
I think the civil society also has not taken an active role in saying enough is enough.
Mm.
Let's, and the whole issue of accountability, it runs across everybody, not just in the state, in the civil society and the market forces.
Okay.
The market forces always is not bad.
Hmm.
It can be good too,
provided
it is channelized through proper transparency
and
some kind of principles. But the principles are missing. That's what bothers me.
Okay, that would certainly give us a lead into our next segment, which is going to be on the course correction. Now it's time to take a very short break in public forum. Please stay tuned. Welcome back to Public Forum. In Public Forum today, we are discussing the dark shadows on culture, and it's time now to discuss as to how the course correction can be done and what is the responsibility of the cultural icons. Okay, Ms. Vasanthi, let's start the discussion with you, because you talked about the non-state players, that is, one of it is, of course, the civil society.
Yeah.
We have the social leaders, we have the NGOs, we have the spiritual leaders,
cultural
and of course,
leaders,
educationists, artists.
Yes.
What role can this can they play here?
I think we've always had very strong non-state players. Today, the non-state players also include sportsmen.
Hmm.
They include Hollywood stars, Bollywood stars. Our icons are changing, but period, as I mentioned, and I think we're all struggling to find the right balance to maintain the global forces that are flood of information that comes through us, yet trying to be grounded to our cultural values, and festivals like Diwali are a highlight of that, this conflicting information. These cultural icons, the non-state players, whether it's civil society, whether it's sports people, whether it's cinema stars, whether the dancers, have a very important role in maintaining and sustaining our culture through generations. However, do we give them enough importance, or do they have a forum to be able to, we used to go out and go to plays, for example. We used to go to the Nukkad Nataks, for example. Where do we go? We don't even have parks nowadays to play.
Hmm.
All that, everything happens is on the television or on the print media or the internet now. Hmm. And there only the dominant voices get heard. As she rightly pointed out, they all, I am to be blamed, nobody else. I chose the government I get. The television that I don't like watching is because I chose it.
Hmm.
I watch it, that's why I get the television.
There's a simple rule of economics.
Absolutely.
That is, there has to be a demand.
Exactly.
There has to be a demand. And
We are not yet become a proactive, discerning citizens first.
Hmm.
Once we do that, then comes everything else will fall into place. We very quietly sit down and say, okay, let the non-state players are not doing a job. State players are not doing the job. Humse kya hoga? Kuch nahi hoga. That lack of faith, the lack of hope has disappeared. And I'm hoping that this Diwali, while wishing all the viewers, I hope that this Diwali lights that small spark of hope and gives us the motivation, the inspiration to do something instead of just sitting and saying,
but you know,
complaining.
These non-state players, they also are a part of the larger population we are talking about. And it's very important to address the issue of, you know, the demand, because the media, the market forces, they might just get away by...
They are very proud about it and then talking about it. Then there's something wrong there. You have to sit back and think, where am I pushing my child? In which direction? Today it is 2 lakhs. Tomorrow it will be something else. And if day after he doesn't have the means, he will mentally become so disturbed that he's not able to play that game with that kind of money. So the giant in the middle class has somehow, we have to knock on its doors or to really think that where are we taking our culture. This is India we are talking about. Mm-hmm. We have to put our foot down and say that no gambling on Diwali night. That's it. There will be differences of opinion. There will be some people who will not like it. But somebody has to stand up and say, this night is not meant for gambling. It is meant for tapasya. It is meant to do the practices as given to you by your guru. That is the only way that you can benefit from this night and benefit everything around.
That the way you are spending, what is it going to do to the environment and how can you sustain yourself? So the ethics of public spending, I think the need for us to raise questions around that within the educational curriculum through state laws. And I think those are the two areas you can actually catch. The family is something. The family is something you can't catch. You can't really. You can of course give out messages, but the public discourse has to be generated. Apart from this particular public discourse, I think that the larger point for us to see is that there is an international framework already on issues around environmental degradation and the rest of it, and whether it is possible for some of us to now see that connection with the kind of things that are happening around Diwali, or to look at labor legislation and to take a look at what's happening to the labor market here, to take a look, and maybe that is where the public discourse can be generated. Human rights, definitely. Human rights, the violation of human rights through the heavy spending on Diwali. What happens to, you know, even in the sense, what happens to the ethic, wherever we live.
Even today.
And that is our moral authority.
That is our moral authority.
I think India would do much better if it played up on this. This moral authority that we have as a nation state. And that is why I think it does not hamper anybody. It adds to our own cultural heritage. At the same time, it adds to our power, to the power that India had as a civilizational, you know, state. So I think somewhere
I totally agree with you that we can really, really capitalize on the idea of what the yogis have been practicing and saying, and bring these things out into the public forum through channels like yours. And I think a program like this that you've done today is going to really have people thinking. It's going to begin the thinking, at least.
And it's very important with these initiatives to at least generate the awareness among the people, let them, differentiate between the...
Self-regulation is some values that you've drawn for yourself.
That's right.
Which you know that this is my value and I'm practicing it.
And
if I fall, you'll hold me accountable. But that's not what is happening. For example, I can clearly see that not happening with the media, especially the private media, because I study the media at the same as Media Lab. We've been doing trends for the last 8 to 10 years, and I've clearly seen that they may preach in a tagline something, but actually practice completely different. So who's holding them accountable? It's this. We're not holding each other accountable. I think this is a very important practice that we've forgotten. I think we need to revive that.
Okay, so on that very important note, we'll take a very short break, and after the break, we'll certainly continue with the course correction aspect and what could be the role of the state here. We'll discuss that. Welcome back to Public Forum. In Public Forum today, we are talking about the dark shadows on culture, and it is impossible to bring any change in the society without the involvement of the state. In this segment, we'll talk about this.
Ideas and values is happening. And I think it does have a very strong role, but it, unfortunately, politicians are coming from the same society. They're not coming from space. So if the society is corrupted of values, so are our leaders. So we have to work on, you know, even building there. If we actually at family level, at institutional level, strengthen these institutions, democratic institutions, and strengthen self.
Strengthen the self.
I think this is going to emerge. It's not a slow process. It's not going to happen tomorrow. I agree. I'm hopeful yet, but not pessimist. I do think that, you know, we are going to go through that. It's a transition stage. Nothing is all bad and hunky dory. I agree, but we'll have to give it time. We'll have to let the churning happen and hope that the Indian values are so strong in us that it will survive.
Absolutely. We'll certainly have to question this. The state will have to question as to why is it turning a blind eye on it. But what can it really do?
May die because I have an asthmatic attack because of the kind of smog you've raised Diwali. So I think the state can play a major role here, also in regulating the market, definitely regulating noise pollution. There are senior citizens in different colonies who can suffer majorly because of the kind of noise pollution that happens due to crackers. There are examinations around the collar. Young people may suffer, so there are health hazards here. There's this, and also there's this pressure, and there could be also environmental hazards. Apart from that, there are accidents. Mainly because of drinking and gambling. So I think it's a larger, I think the state can play a major role here.
That's right.
But I think the other thing that the state needs to play here is to then revive that. It can't just be about Diwali. You can't just pick on Diwali. So you will have to look at the larger behavior, the human behavior that manifests itself through the state. And that needs to be, I think, controlled.
And generating awareness at the same time. Yes, checking the corrupt, as I said. Absolutely. Checking the wrong practices. Absolutely. Checking those who are misusing their power.
The right to information is a major area.
He stands for.
Right.
I mean, highlighting it and making it. Now, a program like this is going to go to so many thousand homes. It is going to get people thinking, reinforcing. And another point that I want to bring in is that Diwali is also about giving. Diwali is also about giving, which is a very, very important aspect of our cultural practices. In fact, that's one of the questions which I wanted to ask you. That is, what should an ordinary citizen do on a day like this? How significant?
Yes, since I told you in the beginning about the energies being at their height, at their peak, and these can be, you know, you can invoke them for something good within your own self. Yes, one of the most important things that every human being can do is service and charity on this night. It's a very, very simple way. And it was, in some ways, it was being practiced many, you know, the whole idea of taking a box of sweets to someone else is based on that principle. And the purest of things are used for using in the havan. The purest of chanting is done. And havans are always, always done for the benefit of mankind, the whole of creation. There is never a personal thought which motivates the doing of a havan on that night. So the entire night is absolutely meant for higher values, higher practices, purification of the self by the service and charity. That is how you're supposed to spend the Diwali night.
Okay. So on that very, very important note, it's time here to thank all three of you. Thank you very much for
talking. Thank you and happy Diwali.
Thank you very much. Well, we have certainly a variety of views, not one that is complementary to contemporary society's intelligence and to the state's sense of responsibility towards Indian culture. The only lesson to be drawn from the discussion is that change begins with ourselves. That means each one of us. On that note, we say goodbye.